Hello, today's topic is Indian developers versus Ukrainian developers. Usually when you decide between for offshore outsourcing, then two places where you outsource or possibly can outsource is India and Ukraine. In this video, we are going to explain the differences and in which situation which would be better for you. So let's dive right in. First, look at the number of developers. In India, you have 5 million developers, and in the Ukraine, it's around 90,000, according to which sources you use for referring. Even a company like Tata Consultancy Company has more than 300,000 IT professionals. So even that is almost three or four times what is in the Ukraine. But the argument which come from many people is that in the Ukraine, the quality of the code and the quality of the developers is higher than in India. This is true, but let's check what we need to check also. It's absolute numbers versus percentage. Of course, in the Ukraine, maybe of those 90,000 developers, 50% might be very good. This would come to around 45,000 very good developers. In India, this percentage might be only 20%, which is much lesser than that 50% of the Ukraine. But if you look at the absolute numbers, that is, India has 5 million developers and 20% of them are really good, then you have 1 million good developers, which is around 20 times more than the Ukraine has. Then let's look at code quality. The other argument which is always brought against India is that the code quality is very low. And that might be true, because when you look at how many bad developers there are and how many good developers there are, then of course there will be many experiences with the bad developers. Because not everyone is going to select 20% of the best ones. And in the Ukraine, the chance of getting a bad developer is less because almost everyone goes into coding because they like it. In India, it's more like the parents say, okay, it's a good job opportunity for you, so go into IT. So the decision is not taken by the student in India to go into IT, but from the parents and from society. And of course, because the IT sector is so huge in India. But in the Ukraine, most probably someone, a student, will go into coding or in software development only if they are convinced of the opportunities and what they can do with coding. So it might be true, but as I said, you also need to look at the 20% good developers in India. So basically what you would need to do is to select the best ones, and that way you will have an equal quality coming out. Let's look at the next point, which is the price. The price is much higher in the Ukraine because there are only 90,000 developers and it is very near to Europe. Mostly the big companies will hire from there, so the charge is much higher. So basically in the Ukraine, an IT company usually will charge between $4,000 and $8,000 per month, which is only affordable to very big companies or to companies which have that kind of cash flow. But if you look at India, the prices are still very low, even though there was an argument that the prices will rise to a European level or to an Eastern European level in the next few years. It didn't happen. The prices are still low. So when you look at the price, then you can really save if you go to India. If you have the budget, then of course Ukraine is also a very good place. So basically you would need to check a few things when deciding where you want to outsource. One thing would be, example, the time difference. The time difference between Europe, Western Europe and Ukraine is just 1 hour. So if you want to have a larger portion of your time working together with the developers, then definitely Ukraine is a good place because the differences are so small. But if you look at India, India's time difference is also not that big. Currently it's 3.5 hours. So the time which you can get to work together is around 4 to 5 hours, which should be also enough. So in most cases, I would say that India is sufficient. Only if you have that kind of time critical tasks which need to be done at the same time, then Ukraine is better. Also the budget. The budget we also discussed. If you have a high budget, then definitely go to Ukraine. If you need to save on budget, go to India. Are you ready to accept cultural differences? In India, the cultural difference is a little bit higher to Western Europe than, for example, the Ukraine. Because Ukraine, after the Cold War ended, Ukraine became more westernized. The same can be also said for India. So people nowadays use WhatsApp, Facebook, YouTube, and watch American movies, eat American food, McDonald's, and so on. So the cultural differences has become less, but of course, India has its own culture, and if you want to work with India, you might need to accept a few things and change how you work with developers. One example would be, for example, Indians usually are not that expressive. So if you want to know more about them, you usually need to ask more questions. And also, it is always better to do it in a written form, because then people can take time and write. And the next question would be, do you need to build bigger teams? In the Ukraine, it might be difficult to get immediately like 20 PHP developers or 20 ASP.NET developers. But in India, for example, it could be that many PHP developers are already available and can be hired very quickly. So if you want to build smaller teams, then go to Ukraine, and if you want to build bigger teams, then go to India. But of course, I'm not saying that building smaller teams cannot be done, because, for example, in my company, we are building smaller teams for companies from Europe. So do you have no time to select candidates? If you want to outsource to India, definitely you need to take your time to select the right candidates. For example, in my company, I help companies from Europe to hire the right candidates, and we have a selection process. So that takes a little bit of time, and it is not immediate. But if you look at Ukraine, because the percentage of good developers is so high, the chances that you're getting a good developer is also very high. So if you have no time, then definitely go to Ukraine if you're looking for the long term, and have time to select candidates, then India is a good choice. Thank you for your time. I hope I could help you with the decision about Ukraine or India. If you want to know more about this topic, you can go also to www.softwaredeveloperindia.com, and there are also a few articles about Ukraine in India. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to this channel if you liked the content. More information will come to different topics about offshoring and outsourcing as well. Thank you very much.